Welcome to Trading Nation. I'm Eric Chemi. All right, the major stock market indices plunging into correction territory today. But a new poll says Wall Street optimism isn't dead. Today we're joined by DataTrek co-founder Nick Colas. I know, Nick, you just finished conducting the special survey among financial professionals on what they think about market conditions. And we got this exclusive sneak peek on the results here at Trading Nation. So let's get right into it. Where are stocks going to bottom in 2018?
Well, we asked that question of our survey respondents, and the overwhelming majority, roughly 54%, thought that stocks would bottom somewhere between down 10 and down 20% from closing levels at the end of last year. So while on the upside, they have identified a level where they want to buy and where they think the bottom will put in, we are not there yet, even with the pullback today.
Okay, so that's sort of the bottoming out expectation there. What about end of year, just the final result after everything goes up and down? What are those expectations for S&P 500 gains or losses for the whole year?
Yeah, the respondents were a little more optimistic. 45% said they thought the market would be up between 5 and 20%, pretty much towards the low end of that band from the end of 2017. So a kind of slightly below average year, call it 5 to 10%. And a further 30-odd percent, 32%, thought that the market would end roughly where it is right now as of Thursday's close. So there wasn't a lot of pessimism that the overall year was going to be down. And in fact, the plurality of respondents said the market would still be up on the year.
Okay, now let's move into something more specific. Let's look at some sectors here. You asked about the best performing sectors for the year. What did your survey respondents say will come out on top?
The top three in order were financials first, then technology, and finally energy. Each one of those had over 20% of the respondents answer that that would be the best performing sector.
Interesting. So when you make a look at, you know, just the whole thing in summary, what does that tell you? What is your overall market view based on all the answers that you saw?
Yeah, as we went through the answers over the weekend and looked at the market action today, it all fit in very nicely because investors haven't lost confidence overall in equities. This is not a replay of, say, 2008 when a lot of investor confidence was destroyed. This is more an understanding and realization that markets have been toppy for a while, valuations are quite high, and investors are looking for a better entry point and they expect more volatility to come. And that fits very neatly with why we're not seeing a lot of buying on days like today. Investors are looking for a level, we're just not there yet.
And then when we think about a day like this, it looks like, it feels like, it sounds like, oh, this could be the bottom. But then again, it's the day where we're crossing the 200-day moving average in the S&P 500. So it suggests that maybe the bottom's got to keep going. Maybe it didn't bounce back, so the bottom is so much further from here. Like, do you look at those 200-day moving average? Do you look at technicals like that? How do you process a move like what's happening here?
We look less at technicals and focus a lot more on fundamentals. And there's no doubt that valuations are rich by most historical measures, even when you factor in very low interest rates. And so for most of our clients, they're fundamentally oriented. They want to know that they can buy the S&P at 14 or 15 times earnings instead of 17 or 18 times earnings. And those are the levels they're going to be interested in more than just the technical levels. They probably coincide to some degree in that neither side is happy. The technicians aren't happy. The fundamental guys aren't happy. And that's what causes this pullback. There's nobody willing to step in because it's hit their level.
Okay. So that's a good summary where things are. And how often are you running this survey? Is this annual? Is this quarterly? When do we see the next one coming out?
We do a quarterly survey on a whole variety of different factors, and we pick and choose based on what's going on in the market as to what to ask.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.